Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. I hope you're able to hear me. Right? A very good morning, and my many, many congratulations to about 180 odd students who are beginning a new phase of their life. EGDM and MMS are wonderful courses to pursue, not just from a future economic stability and growth perspective, but in terms of the ability that you will get at the end of those 2 years of being able to serve the nation and the world in a wonderful manner. Because the course objective of any PGDM or MMS is to ensure that you have the skills to marshal whatever resources that are there available so that greatest amount of benefit can be delivered to humankind. So you are going to be the tools of progress of tomorrow. In fact, in the morning when I was having a chat with Mr. Saraf and I was hearing the kind of achievements that the entire Rajasthani Sammelan as well as the Dugali Saraf Institute have been doing in the past few years, it is quite astounding to be in a position to serve 15,000 students every year and to ensure that not just the rich but also the very, very poor and downtrodden have their place in the society is indeed a wonderful objective. And you, as new students of this institution, are part of this legacy from here onwards. So my many congratulations to you to start with. Dr. Babu mentioned that India is possibly the only country which can supply manpower to the world. And in fact, it's true. I can quote one more such study which has been done by the World Economic Forum, which says in the next 20-25 years, say by around 2035, 25% of the world's working population will be Indian. 25% of the world's working population will be Indian because India is a young country. We are a very ancient country, but a very young nation. Young, as an identity, we are only about 67, 68 years old. But most importantly, in terms of the composition of the population, most of our people are below 35. And those 35 and so people will continue to contribute to the world for the next 30 years without any problems. And that is a humongous opportunity for us as a country and you as an individual to tap. I'm going to be too late, too old by 2035, so I may not be able to participate in that, but my best wishes will be with you. Now, what does it mean for us? It simply means that the age-old maxim that our forefathers have left for us, and I know many of you will not understand Tamil, but there is a saying in Tamil. It simply says that Thirai Kadaloti Dravyam Thevi. That means that cross the seven seas and earn money. That means your business or your area of interest or whatever you do need not be restricted to your little geography of your town or village or country. The entire world is your football field and the football is there with you and there is no opponent. So as many goals as you are able to score in that game, it is to your credit. If you fail to score even a single goal, obviously that's not very desirable, but the opportunity is there in front of you to do whatever you want. And as time goes by and as this country grows and develops further and further, you will see many, many more doors open in front of you than what probably my previous generation or even our own generation is facing. So the world is opening up. And therefore, it is up to us to be skilled, it is up to us to be worthy of taking that opportunity and going forward. Now, when we talk about management institution, now it is exactly 27 years that I was in a similar position to yours, way back in 1987 when I stepped into IIM Ahmedabad. I had a lot of butterflies in my stomach, I didn't know what was going to happen. Of course, I must admit that I was in a better position than most of the students who joined with us, because I had already completed my CA and I had actually acquired 1 year work experience in the industry. So it wasn't completely Greek and Latin for me. But even then, there were a lot of misgivings on what's going to happen, how things will be, etc., etc. Now, over the next 2 years, what I really learned was that management is not a set of books. Management is not a set of, you know, transportation problems and algorithms and formulae, right? But management is an art, it's not a science. How you practice management is far more important than what you actually learn in the classroom. What you learn in the classroom is important. It gives you the techniques. But personally, what I learned outside of the classroom was probably 20 times more valuable than what I learned in the classroom. And we used to have a very tough life in IIM Ahmedabad. Minimum work days used to be 14 hours. And after that, you had to have some fun. You have to obviously take care of your personal requirements, like, you know, eating and relaxing and so on and so forth, taking care of your clothes. And yet, you had enough time to have fun. So 14 days or 14 hours of working, and whenever you feel that, you know, you've actually become very efficient in terms of your studies and all that, you can complete that in 12 hours, the professors will be there to ensure that you get some 7 hours of more work that day. So effectively, every day we used to sleep for about 3 hours. So even today, when I came back, you know, in 1989, I came home, I used to be very used to sleeping for 2.5 to 3 hours a day. And in those days, you didn't have 24-hour TV. TV used to be switched off at 9:30 or 9:45. And there was no radio beyond 12 o'clock either. So I used to sit in my bed like an owl, waiting for sleep to come. Then over a period, that 2.5 hours has now become 5 in 26 years. So, but those 5 hours, I consider as a waste. Simply because those are the hours which is of course necessary to ensure that your body is kind of regenerating itself. But those 5 hours are lost as far as the mind is concerned. So how to economize on the time available? That means time management that Dr. Babu spoke about was very critical from everybody's perspective in terms of how to deliver more in terms of results and in terms of desirable outcomes, given a certain limited amount of time. You have 24 hours, I have 24 hours, he has 24 hours. But what we do individually in those 24 hours actually makes the difference between a success and a failure. Second factor as far as time is concerned, one of the key things that I learned as part of the management education was that management is ultimately dealing with men. Managing men is what management is all about. Right? Now, how do you manage men? It is not by dhanda. You can't whip people up and ensure that they work. That can work. That is the Taylor's theory of how to make people more and more efficient by becoming ruthless. I think that ruthlessness does not work in the longer run. But what really works very well is giving respect, ensuring that you are able to take people along, is what makes you a great leader. Now, if you have to give respect to people, the first thing that you should do is to ensure that your timing is maintained. That if a certain meeting is supposed to start on time at, let's say, 10 o'clock, you better be there at 10 o'clock. If a movie starts at 10 o'clock, you're always there at 10 o'clock. So why should attending classes or going to a meeting or even keeping a social engagement be any different? Right? The airline is not going to wait for you to take off, right? It will leave anyway. So you better be on time. Likewise, if you respect people and if you want to show your respect to people, always be on time. That's the second thing that I learned. The third thing that I learned was when two or more individuals interact with each other, there is always going to be politics.